If you consider changing automatic transmission fluid on your own, you'll probably know that accurately measuring ATF temperature is crucial to ensuring it's at the correct level. This typically means using specialized software or a professional OBD2 scanner with brand-specific modules. These scanners can be expensive, like the Xtool D7 priced at $400. But here is the question. Can you achieve the same results with a more affordable scanner? Specifically, can a basic OBD2 scanner, such as the $30 BAFX Bluetooth interface, accurately measure ATF temperature? Welcome to Professor's Garage. In this video, I'm going to settle the questions, walk you through the process. Let's dive right in. As I have shown in my previous videos, the Xtool D7, with its $400 price tag and 3-year software update package, can do the job effortlessly. Just plug it in, start your car, follow the on-screen instructions, select transmissions for your Lexus, and you will see the real-time ATF temperature. It's a top-tier scanner with a price tag to match. Now let's look at another option. The Launch CRP129E is slightly more budget-friendly at $200. While it lacks the bidirectional features of the Xtool D7, it still offers more advanced capabilities compared to a basic OBD2 scanner. Despite its smaller screen, the interface is user-friendly and provides easy-to-read detailed descriptions. To check if we can find the ATF temperature data, let's follow a similar process. Select Lexus, then All Systems, then Transmissions, and finally, Live Data. And there it is, the ATF oil temperature. The value looks reasonable and we'll compare it later. An interesting feature here is the ABS reset actuation feature, among several other reset functions. This is a bonus usually found in bidirectional tools, making the $200 price tag even more appealing. And finally, the ultimate test. Can we measure ATF temperature using a very basic OBD2 scanner? I have had this BAFX Bluetooth interface for years, and it cost me around $20 initially. It's now available for around $30. The setup requires an Android device and a scanner app like Torque, which is free, or Torque Pro for $5. So you may spend around $35 for this combination. The Torque Pro app offers numerous features, but today our focus is on measuring ATF temperature for Toyota or Lexus vehicles. For this Lexus RX350, which shares a similar powertrain with Toyota Highlanders, I use a PID that I found on the Highlander forum from Toyota Nation. In the Torque Pro app, navigate to settings, select manage extra PID sensors, and enter the PID information shown here. I'll provide a copy of this PID in the video description below for your convenience. Before proceeding, make sure to test it. Click test, and it will display the final result along with values for A and B. The temperature value appears correct. Now let's go back to real-time live data and add a display to include this new ATF PID on the app. You can choose any display type, but for precision, I recommend selecting the digital number display. And voila! You now have access to live ATF temperature data with this basic BAFX scanner. While all the ATF temperature readings from the three scanners seem reasonable, the real question is, are they correct? Let's compare them side by side. First, BAFX versus Launch. They are extremely close. Now BAFX versus Xtool D7, and there is a slight variance. After rigorous testing, I can confidently say these scanners provide consistent and accurate readings. In conclusion, you can use the $30 BAFX Bluetooth interface combined with the Torque Pro app to accurately measure ATF temperature for your own DIY ATF replacement. So there you have it. We have demystified the process of measuring ATF temperature using an affordable OBD scanner. Whether you opt for the high-end scanner like the Xtool D7 or mid-range option like the Launch CRP129E, or even a budget BAFX OBD2 paired with the Torque Pro app, the results are impressively consistent. Please note related PIDs are make and model specific. For example, the PID I used here will work for Lexus RX350 or Toyota Highlander. However, I know for a fact that this does not work on the Camry. Such PIDs are available through professional services, manufacturer documentation, or online forums such as Toyota Nations and Lexus Club. So hopefully you will find what you need there. But please do not hesitate to leave a comment below if you have questions or information regarding these PIDs. I hope this video has been helpful and informative. If a professor can do it, you can do it. And if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Until the next time, may the Lord bless you and grant you peace. 平安。